Tonight, a shocking crime, a school system unable to cope, and a father and daughter left fighting for justice. And a warning, this story may be triggering for survivors.
It's been horrific. I don't recognise myself at all, and I haven't for a very, very long time.
He has destroyed my daughter. He has potentially changed her for life.
We're calling this girl Rachel. That's not her real name or voice, but the law prevents us from revealing her identity or that of the young man convicted of attacking her. They were both 16 when they went to a party in the Blue Mountains 3 years ago.
I was so intoxicated that I was not even remotely myself. I started pushing away. I was saying no and kicking him away. And then it all started and lasted for over 2 hours of him raping me and suffocating me. I had never had sex before. Not that this was sex. And I just remember it being so terrifying.
It would be almost a year before Rachel summoned the courage to tell a teacher she trusted that she'd been raped by a classmate.
I didn't tell my parents because I knew it would break their hearts. So I had talked to the deputy principal and she told them for me.
I knew exactly who had raped her because I'd warned the principal and that principal had failed to take action. 4 days after we issued a warning about him being a rape threat to girls at the school, he raped our daughter.
In the months before the attack, a group of boys in Rachel's year were threatening sexual violence against female students and a teacher.
They started explicitly talking about who they wanted to rape. They were talking about gang rape, mainly joking about it.
Rachel and some other girls finally reported their concerns in writing to senior staff.
One teacher who was chosen to talk to the boys explicitly said, and I quote, like, boys will be boys, these things happen. And the whole thing felt so belittling of how scared we all were.
The school promised to have police talk to the young men in question, but on the day police attended, the ringleader was kept home.
We explicitly named this boy because he was the one that I was most worried about.
And as things turned out, her fears were well-founded. The boy was eventually charged with 6 counts of sexual assault and 1 of choking without permission. After the charges were laid against this boy, he was legally allowed to come back to the same school and pass your daughter in the corridor. What did you think about that?
I was appalled. I had assumed that if you get charged with multiple charges of sex assault, that you're not allowed to come back to the same school as the victim. I was totally wrong.
Eventually, the boy's parents decided to move him to another school.
We were told that he did not have to tell the new school that he was up on serious rape charges. And the new school is legally not allowed to know. This is a part of the law that absolutely has to change.
But for Rachel, the harassment didn't stop.
There was people who were giving me the nickname the chick who lies about being raped because they were mates of his. I was being harassed by the little sister after he was arrested, where she would, like, follow me to the bathroom.
The school reported her harassment to the police. The school said you should maybe take out an AVO against the girl. And yet this is happening on school grounds and the principal totally failed to protect her from the rapist's sister.
I'm very well aware that it's been a very harrowing experience for the victim and her family.
The New South Wales Education Minister Sarah Mitchell refused to talk to us, but she was quizzed about the case at a Senate estimates hearing.
Those allegations in terms of that sexual assault did not occur on the school site, but I certainly appreciate in terms of how challenging it must have been for the victim to be at school with her with the offender.
2 years on, the minister has now finally asked the department to look into better supporting victims of crime who attend the same school as their attackers.
We have to balance the rights of both students in this. When these incidents occur, they are invariably managed very well locally within the school context.
Bullshit. absolute bullshit. The school's first reaction was to protect the reputation of the school. Protecting our daughter came second.
He says the education department promised three times in writing to tell them the results of an 18-month investigation into the matter.
They are refusing to tell us what they investigated, and they won't tell us if anybody in the school has faced any consequence for their failure to protect our daughter.
Do you believe that there are other students at your high school who've been raped?
Absolutely. I have no doubt in my mind. There are at least 5 to 8 other women who have been through what I have.
We do know the New South Wales Police have been investigating other reports of sexual assault at Rachel's school.
I have mates who have very lovingly told me, after seeing what you've been through, I would never do it. Like, it's not worth it.
In the past year, there were 158 reports of sexual assault on school grounds made to New South Wales Police. On top of that, there were 519 other sexual offences and more than 600 reports of intimidation, stalking and harassment.
If we're really serious about clamping down on rape of women in Australia, it begins in schools with total zero tolerance towards sex harassment.
I've experienced so much victim blaming. I've had many people say, but you chose to drink that night, as if that means that drinking at a party inherently means you deserve to be raped then.
The Children's Court found the teenage boy guilty and last month sentenced him to at least 2 months' jail.
He was out on bail within a couple of hours. How does that make you feel?
I have left this court process feeling like I was raped all over again by the system. I think it sends a message to every other rapist and predator out there that I can do this and I get a slap on the wrist.
Rachel is considering taking legal action against the department and the school, but most of all, she just wants change.
I have an incredible little sister who's one of my best friends, who I do most of this for, just wanting to make things safer for her and make it better than what it was for me.
I know how hard you've fought for your girl over the last 2 years. How are you doing?
I'm not doing very well. It's been really hard because I want justice for my daughter. We have been blocked at every turn, all our questions unanswered. And I am going to keep fighting until I get those answers.
My dad has been an absolute hero through all of this. He's absolutely turned his life upside down to take care of me and has absolutely saved my life more times than I think he'll ever know.
Well, the Director of Public Prosecutions has this week confirmed it's considering a request from the New South Wales Attorney General to appeal the sentence given to the girl's attacker. And you'll find further statements from Education Minister Sarah Mitchell and the department on our website.
Meanwhile, if this story has raised any issues for you, you can contact 1-800-RESPECT. So that number is 1800 737 732 or Lifeline 13 11 14.